energy drink because I'm gonna 3 o'clock, 9 more hours ago.
Okay, see you in a bit then.
That's rough, buddy.
There it goes.
Finally done.
Ooh.
It only took several hours.
Yeah, you've been working on that, like, the entire time.
Yeah, a lot of it. That's okay. Okay. Kids are into something.
What's up?
Not much.
Oh. So cool on you sometimes, I swear.
Hello.
There. Hello.
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 No, criminal. This is forbidden. Our
question is,
I like to do that all the time.
Who did it? It sounds like Crash, but it seems more like Fred.
That I'm pretty sure that's Kirsty. There's Fred, and Crash isn't here, so it was a Kirsty.
That was
that
a
was you.
It was a yeah.
Yo, yeah, we need to get you playing a goblin.
Hello.
Well, if we do it one shot.
We had the opportunity. I'll just curse doing fun, boys.
Nice. Well, you can be a goblin if you play one shot with me, Kirsty.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Then you can fight, like, fire-breathing T-Rexes or something. No, I know.
Can I be a golden that rides a fire-breathing T-Rex?
Maybe? I mean, you can go look for one, I guess.
Find it.
That's it. I'll just derail the entire campaign for this, for the fire-breathing T-Rex.
Derail the campaign? You found the true meaning of the campaign if you do that.
Oh, dear.
I'm back.
Hello. If you think for a second we all wouldn't support you in your fire-breathing T-Rex rampage, you're mistaken.
What?
Don't worry about it. Anyways. <I'm>
I have,
yes.
Across the street neighbors, which is like a frat house, and they're actually alright, but that's because I have a room in the back of my house. Uh-huh. But no, dead ass, I went to the bathroom right now, which is also towards the back of the house, so that's how loud this was. I heard one of them, I'm not sure if he was trying to do it, but it fucking sounded like it, like Goofy from, you know, fucking the Goofy movie. Like, not like a yuck, sort of like, that's like that sort of like howl, like scream he does when he's like, oh, yeah, that one, yeah. I dead ass just heard that when I was pooping in the bathroom. I was like, what?
Am I in the Goofy movie? Am I going to the X Games?
Yeah, I was like, no, I was just like, why though? I don't know. They're watching the Goofy movie right now. One of them has a really good impression. I don't know. Yeah, I can see a frat house do this. It's like, dude, Goofy movie on. Dude, what's up?
It's a good ass.
Hey, dude, Frank has a really good Goofy impression. Dude, Frank, do the impression. Do the impression. I could 100% see it happening. I know this because it happened in my dorm hall. So.
Was it Shiv?
No, Shiv didn't have any good impressions.
Shame. He just had a dope ass name.
And he serenaded me in the shower. He was an okay singer. There are definitely worse people that serenaded me in the shower.
No, oh, God.
Like his roommate, John.
Actually, serenading people in the shower is just like a normal thing.
No, that's happened. Anytime one of them saw, because I was the only one in the hall that had a bathrobe. That's because I do. So they also, you sort of knew who was in the shower by the towel. Like, you sort of just learned it. Like, different people had different color towels. So anytime it's one of those two, those two, it's like specifically that room. They both share the room, right? The roommates. It's like, If it was Shiv, like, Jeff, is that you in there? Yeah, you know it's me, Shiv. Yeah, you know it's me. If it was John, dude, Jeff, is that you in there?
They're the same person.
They picked each other for roommate status or something, because you could lock in roommates if you know them ahead of time and request them. Mm-hmm. And they did that. they didn't know each other prior, but they sort of like found like there's like a big Facebook group thing which were like trying to find roommates and stuff like that. I didn't do shit for it. I didn't know my roommates. I met them the day of. But anyways,
nice.
Yeah, they both would serenade me in the shower, whereas Shiv would actually sort of try to serenade me. John would be like, fucking. Let's just don't stop believing as an example. He just shout. It's not even see. He just be shouting. Don't stop believing. No, I'm just like, thanks, John. Fucking really doing it. So yeah, Shiv would actually sort of try to sing, but John didn't. Yeah. So those are my. Which is super weird. Anytime I saw John on campus, he'd be super chill. Like, oh, hey, Jeff, dude, you coming back from class? Yeah, no, I'm actually waiting for him right now. Oh, hey, that's what's up, dude. Yeah, it was really weird. So John, when he had privacy with you versus John in public, two very different people. What a magical thing. And then Shiv always got sex eye without him.
I believe that's called a social introvert.
Yeah, I guess so, yeah. I mean, I'm happy that he could open up to me.
Nice.
No, I was like super. I didn't give a shit about anything. So it's like, let's see. What am I at the end of the hall? There's like a trio room, and one of them, his name was Jorge. He was super chill. He was like a little bit shorter than me, but he was like really buff. Actually, no, not buff. He was very lean. He had like a runner's physique. That's the best way to describe it. So he had muscles like. For like running and soccer and stuff like that.
Right.
And I remember I offhandedly asked him when we were brushing our teeth, like I just happened to see him there. It's not like we scheduled or anything, but I just offhandedly, this was like right before finals, or no finals week, yeah. I offhandedly was like, oh, hey, Jorge, okay, you have any Adderall? And he
deadpan.
He like looked at me, toothpaste on his toothbrush, about to brush his teeth. He just dead in the eye, looked at me. Dude. The campus is out of that. And I was like, what do you mean the campus is out of that? Like, the pharmacy, like, down the way where everyone can get all their, like, prescriptions? Yeah. They're out. What? I was like, did you have an influence on that? Alright.
Continues brushing teeth.
I appreciate that if he was some, he would have sold me some, like a proper dealer, but there wasn't any. So, and he just outright told me that there wasn't any. I was like, all right, man.
SOL, mate.
And now you know why he has a runner's physique.
Because he's running for the
night. Right. Shit, you're right. I think he was in the recreational soccer team as well. Like, actually. Not like the actual, like, team for the university, but just like on the
having a good time.
What's it called? Like an amateur league or whatever is what it's called, right? Sure. Something like that. Yeah. Anyways, we're all back. Yes, is Fred here?
I believe Fred was here.
Yeah.
He's muted, so he might not be here.
He was here a minute ago.
Did you just turn on your Xbox?
Mm-hmm. Might just be. No, I'm in a car. I have to drop off some box.
I didn't even hear anything that would have sounded. I didn't hear anything. I didn't hear a car start up or an Xbox start up. I didn't hear
it. There's a faint boing noise. Yeah. There's Brad.
No, I was here all along. Yeah.
You're muted, so I didn't know.
Yeah, I'm chewing on very loud almond treats.
Thank you.
Okay, that's what's up.
So
those are loud.
Damn, no, that's not. No, that sounds like a sound effect. That sounds like a sound effect. ASMR. That's clean. Like someone biting chips right next to the mic. Anyway, so
should we get one in the recording?
Speaking of snacks and stuff, yeah, you guys begin leaving Expeditionary HQ to go to the Wayfarer's Fork. Alrighty.
Roll D100 for Serial Killer.
Well, I will ask one of you to roll a D100.
Sure.
Elector representative.
I can do it.
Yeah, go for it.
Yeah, go for it.
Oh my god!
Oh my goodness.
I'm only mad that it's not 100 because that goes on a record.
Yeah.
There's someone that has two 100s in my Wednesday game, and he's very proud of it. Very proud of it.
Downside, that's usually not a good... Well, I mean, like, if it's a random chart.
No, they were never good things in those cases.
Oh god!
One of them took three levels, or 3 points of intelligence, but gave him a Warlock level. So I guess that's sort of winning, I guess.
I guess?
He has a higher proficiency bonus than everyone else because he's one more level.
I guess. But he's also slightly more insane.
Oh, yeah. And I told him, yeah, you can continue on Warlock as long as you keep serving. If not, then I'm going to drain your intelligence. But yeah, 99. And full transparency, there's only four things. There's 1 to 25, okay. 26 to 50.
Like a 50 quarter percent chance.
Yeah,
on each one.
Quarter. Yeah.
What the fuck?
Quarter chance. So, yeah. I already know this off the top of my head. So, do I need a marching order from you? No, probably not. Why would you ask this?
Marching order?
Well, I want to know who's in front, basically.
Wait, we're going to the bar?
Ruhan.
Yeah, you're on the bar.
I'm in front.
Mm-hmm. He's in front by like 10 feet.
Yeah, okay. So yeah, you guys are going back to, or going not back to, going to, I guess, or back to for Ruhan, going to the Wayfarer's Fork. So that's, you know, you got all these lovely icons for a reason, right? It's, you know, like 5 miles. There might be like some trams that you guys could take, especially down Main Street, that sort of accelerate the process. But anyways, as you guys are in the market district, sort of walking to, so on the latter half of the journey, walking to the Wayfarer's Fork, you guys see a group of people approaching you. And I should say this. It's not like there's not a lot of people out. There are a lot of people out. But like, it's the fact that they, similar to you guys, form their own party for to consolidate a presence. That makes sense. Like those like assholes on the sidewalk that block the way by standing in a line together.
I hate those.
And you can't walk past them. Yeah, like that. Mm-hmm. Except this one isn't as asshole if people can't get around them. Yeah, it looks to be some house guard. So, noble house guardsman. It's sort of like a diamond formation, except the tops and bottoms of the diamond are like flattened, so that the points are flat. So it's like this weird hexagonal formation, I guess. Elongate hexagon formation. Doesn't roll off the tongue as well. Rose, you recognize this person. You have talked to him about the shard. This is your... The noble.
What was his name again?
Franco Calsus. So this is Lord Calsus.
Oh, nice.
And true to when you did visit him, the couple of times you visited him, his honor, or not honor guard, his house guard, quite the imposing looking force. Looking rather, they're very well armed, very well armored, though I could say the same for you guys. But they do have that sort of like thuggish demeanor to them. And yeah, they're coming down the street towards you guys. So, like, sort of, not blocking your path, but just, like, you guys are on the same fucking sidewalk, and they're going that way or this way.
But it doesn't look like they're coming at us, they're just going down the street.
No, yeah, they're coming at your direction, not to you.
Very important difference there.
As you get closer, Lord Kausis does spy you. Ah! It's Rose.
Oh, hi.
Hello. Evening. He, like, puts his hat and does, like, a... You know, like a, how do you do?
Just wave. So what has you out tonight?
Just getting some fresh air, a nice walk, maybe do some late night shopping, things of that nature. Hmm. And what about you? I haven't seen you in quite a while. Busy with expeditionary work, I assume.
Oh yeah, traveling to very interesting places.
Oh? Like what? Anything related to that thing you showed me?
Disappointingly, no. More related to other things.
Any remnants, by any chance? He has, like, a toofy smile.
Yeah. I don't think so. Ruhan has the mask still, right? He didn't get rid of that.
He should still have it. You guys didn't stop by Darren or anything.
No, we did not.
Yeah. Best bet would be maybe the mask over there, but I highly doubt it.
Oh, no. That can't be anything from a remnant.
Yeah.
What is a remnant? Sorry to intrude.
Oh, no.
Who is this?
Yeah, this is Raze. He's new to our group. And then she would go through and introduce everyone else in the group. It's like, yes, this is Ruhan.
Pleasure. Good to meet you.
He really wants to...
You! You seem to be carrying something quite heavy there, friend. Would you like some momentary assistance while we're having this conversation? Don't answer that. Lads! Help him. They both look at one another. You can see a couple of them like slump, like, huh? They hold out their arms like shelves to help carry the plates if you so offer it. Like dropping it on them like a rich person drops the bags into their caddy's hand.
Yeah, I'm just gonna make it look a lot lighter than it actually is while I'm handing it to them.
No, but they get it.
roll your deception with. Oh wait, you're not. I'll roll for you. I'll roll deception with strength, which I think might just be a straight check for you. You have deception training. Mm-hmm. Oh, right? No, you did. Okay. All right, plus +7. Baby.
You want no. Take a D8 for that. Take my last party die for that. That sounds like it'd be fun. D10.
Yeah. Oh, it's a 13. I need that D10.
Hey, that's a good ass 8. 21.
Yeah, hey, there you go.
Worth
it. 21. It
was,
hey, you remember it was there, though.
Yeah, it's good. You guys could have taken a short rest while you guys were in Gaul's office, or on his doctor's table. So you should still have all your bardic inspirations.
Oh, well, there we go.
There you go. Well, now you have one less.
I have four.
So yeah, Ruhan, you like... go to give it to him, and you're just like, oh, it's not, like, you even hold it out, like a set of them with, like, one arm, just like, oh, yeah, it's not that bad, and then you just sort of gently place it into their arms, and they're just like, oh, it's not that bad, then you finally fully let go, and they're like,
Oh my,
someone help him, please, someone. The two guys are carrying it. It's like carrying, a really small, thin couch. That's heavy as fuck. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you. Really?
Yeah.
That's not a remnant, but that is impressive, I must say. Puts his hat back on. So, where are you off tonight?
Be drinking stuff.
Well,
any bar in specific?
You could probably guess.
I actually can't.
Oh, really? The Wayfarer's Fork.
Ah. Let's go. I didn't guess, so I would have guessed wrong.
What would you have guessed?
This is Crash looking up past information about where Tanum hung out a lot. That bar.
Oh, yeah, it was the bar. It was the one next to Bard's College, right?
With Marcone.
No, not the one of Marcone.
I
think it was called the Writer's Quill? No, it wasn't.
Writer's Crest!
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Yeah. I was going to say the Writer's Quest, actually. Fine, quiet little place. I don't know. But I suppose, given your current... he looks at these straining, thuggish guards, like... I suppose you want a stronger drink from that.
What is Remnant?
That is a very good question.
He smiles wildly. You guys just got a quack scientist person to talk about their Ponzi scheme. Just kidding. Remnology is sort of a real science, sort of.
But also
sort of not. Well, my draconic friend.
And he's off.
It is the archaeological pursuit of very specific types of ruins called remnants. We've done them that. Remnants of an old civilization, older than any colonial elves, older than any far-flung dwarves, older than any giants.
That's not true.
No. It is, my friend. It is. Ancient. Ancient. Alien in its own right. Very little evidence about these. Not evidence. Very little details about what the civilization was like. All we know is that they were immensely magical. Immensely.
He nods along whenever he says it. Whenever he goes immensely up in tone, he nods.
Immensely magical. Beings that might as well have been partially formed of raw magical energy. Imagine that. Being in a semi-ethereal society of everyone having access to magic.
That'd be the law, the memory wear.
Not Loa, yes, it's sort of like Loa. But Loa only some of them were ever alive. Not some of them are undead spirits. This is an entire living society with everything that living entails.
Hold up my grandfather next to my own face and I ask him, a great grandfather. You know anything about this place, this magic?
Actually, he is from this continent. He would be a good bet for that.
Oh, okay, 50, well, 50. Well, yeah, there's your DC. 50-50.
At the 100?
Mm-hmm. It's exactly 50.
Come on, 49. Come on, 49. 45 is good. Close, but got it.
That's so close, Jesus.
Close, mm-hmm. But yes, cigar.
I was talking to my Wednesday group of us. I might actually make a saint called... Not, his name isn't Jesus, but the shortening of his name is Jesus. And he'll be a saint of Zogrir Fenizar, which is sort of a deviant idol god, so goddess, so be careful of that. But it will be like a saint of calamity, which is why everyone drops his name in bad times. Like, Jesus! Like, oh, Jesus. Jesus, no, don't say his name, you might invite him here.
Just rolls up, hey guys, what's going on?
Jesus no! Christ! Jesus Christ, yeah, he must have had a hand in this, you're right.
I love it.
That's then we can, finally, yeah, yeah. That's so we can finally bring it into the fucking setting why there's a why fucking Jesus Christ. Yeah, well, I'll get to it later. I might put it in whenever, but in the monk stuff is. But anyway, so 45. Nice. Grandfather slowly opens his eyes. He awakens. Grandfather awakens. Oh, there will be old ruins. Here, there, everywhere. Some up top, some down deep. Lord Kallus' eyes are like immensely open. He's like, he's pulled out like a little notepad and begins recording down everything, like transcribing what Grandfather's saying. Unfortunately, that's all Grandfather says as he goes back to sleep. When I say sleep, he goes away. Deep. Interesting.
There you have it.
Raze, have you ever been to one of these, or is this mostly just your grandfather? Great-grandfather. Skull.
Raze gone walk about. He see many things. He not know what remnant is.
I'd say a common classification for them. Something that makes it very obvious it's a remnant. Are the defenses. Have you ever gone to any ruined settlements? Places carved of old heavy stone? Where there are guardians still? Defenses. Once powered by magic. Raw magic.
Ray sort of self-consciously scratches the scar on his chest for a quick second. Moves his hand away. There be one place Race can think of.
Is it close? Is it far?
It far. Big inland.
Do you know the way to it? Still.
It go through a place where the path it changed. Tricky business.
Like where we just were at.
But could you find your way to it?
Race maybe could, but Race not too keen on go back.
Well, if you yourself won't return back to the site, would you be willing to guide others to it?
It's at the site.
Maybe. There be a danger in that place. It will raise him have a talk. Him have a talk with him on Shadow. The only place such thing can be done.
Ooh.
That's weird.
Miss Rose. You and Mr. Raze are close, yes? You are competitive associates.
Yeah, let's put it that way. We're on the same squad, yeah.
Mr. Raze, if I were to sponsor an expedition out to this place, would you be willing to lead them? And potentially myself and some others?
What do you have to offer?
Knowledge.
That's a good question.
A lord's favor.
Yeah.
Are you good with making a key weapon?
He gets like a sly smile. I am.
Raise him have purpose. Him is making a weapon to kill many skonken.
What sort of weapon?
Race does not know yet. He will know when he see it.
Well,
Race need 5 things.
5 things. If I might interject, I don't know what those 5 things are, but the knowledge of an ancient civilization might be handy in making a weapon.
Okay. Raise do it. But
hey,
we have a pressing concern. Must look into first.
He holds up 2 Poike events. Of course. I am behest to your scheduling. You are the one that knows the path. I, of course, request expediency, but those remnants have been there for eons. I think they can wait a little longer.
Almost as old as giants.
Older, I assure you.
No, let's not be dramatic.
He's gonna keep this going, don't worry about it.
Yes. Don't worry, I've had this conversation with many experts, particularly of the giant variety.
Wait, really?
Yes.
He is a well-versed person.
We be going to the giant place.
I get into this science lightly, I assure you. But I shan't keep you any longer. It seems that my... he looks at the guys holding the plates. My lads are straining as we speak. And I do have some last minute places to check out. So, and it sounds like you all need to get drinking. So, he reaches into a coin. His coin purse, pours out a platinum piece. On me, my friends, on me.
Oh, I thank you.
Most gracious. When the time comes, Reyes tell Rose. Rose tell you.
Of course.
And Reyes takes the platinum coin.
Have a good night. Evening, night. Whatever you find it. Have a good one.
And
you
as well.
They give back the plates to you, Ruan. They don't have the capacity to do the same trick you pulled on them, so they just outright just plop it into your awaiting hands. And then they part. How do you know Lord Kalsith?
I was looking into there's no need to be facetious. I was looking into the Shard events. And I thought there would be a different light that could be shined on it.
And that's fair.
Yeah. He did actually give me some information, but not a lot. But still.
If it's not a remnant, I imagine it doesn't particularly pique his interest. As evidenced by the immensely, immensely magical nature of the society. She does like air quotations around it.
Oh, yeah. No, he has passion.
Okay. At least something, that's for sure.
He's a second waver. No, was he not? Yeah, he is.
Older than giant.
Abigail and Varric and Ruhan and everybody.
Yes.
A noble, them rich boys. Yeah.
Rich. Some of them earn their titles.
Generally high in power and influence.
Rhys not against going on expedition. But him trust everybody else to negotiate fair bargain.
Lord Kalsith is more than he appears. What makes you say that? The company he keeps, the way he carries himself.
Oh, yeah. If you want to know more, talk to Jesse later.
Of course.
That ruin is because Reyes is scared.
That is an unexpected answer.
Why?
Well, we can find you some liquid courage at the Wayfarer's Fork.
Yeah, wait, why am I even asking? Yeah, let's do that first.
Yeah, it's yeah, standing in the middle of the street talking about most of the shit. Yeah,
let's go.
Honest.
We got the first two rounds sorted.
Yeah, you guys just got two platinum pieces. Just I don't know.
By the way, anybody else? Literally
just gonna be you guys right there.
Yeah. Anybody else got like a rich person that they want to like stop by and have a conversation with real quick? We could like get the entire night sorted.
Well, and potentially get like more money.
Look, I'm not saying. I am entirely saying yes.
100%. Right, so you take those two platinum pieces and you invest in GameStop.
Oh shit! It's crashing again.
Big brain. Diamond hand.
Fantasy GameStop. They just sell board games that have magic in them to make it look visual.
You actually will get diamond hands. A hat comes out and curses you. You have 2-ton diamond hands. But they are worth that as much as 2 tons. They just weigh 2 tons.
You're just stuck there. You have to rip off your hands at the wrists. Anyways.
Oh, it's like 28 hours later? Is that it? 30 hours later?
Yeah, 20.
I don't remember the fucking number.
Actually, maybe 27.
69 hours there for all I care. So, you guys get going. Y'all get going. And you guys arrive at the Wayfarer's Fork. It is busy. It is the middle of the night, after all, on a... I think, what is it? We're on a... Eidos?
We have a calendar for a reason.
I'm trying to remember. No, that's my other... There it is. My other crew is on Eidos. Yeah, yours are on
Didus. We're on
Didus,
8th of Harvest.
Yeah, so 11/9. Tuesday.
Oh shit, are we gonna see, like, the turn of a century? No, wait, no, we're not. What the fuck is wrong with my brain?
I mean, it is a turn of a century.
Sorry, I was thinking, like, 1,000 to 2,000. So I was right, nah, but my thought process was wrong.
Yeah. You were correct the first time. Just like, on tests, they say you should never second-guess yourself. Joke's on them, though. I second-guessed it all. So, yeah, Undyna. So, Tuesday night, equivocally. And it is busy, but